And the next one is about is his attack on a world of a consumerism, where we are convinced that we have to buy things all the time, and those things become part of us and even take us over.
Naturalmente, o consumo é uma coisa super importante, porque nós não podemos viver sem consumir.
We cannot live, of course, without consuming.
O que a gente questiona é toda essa ideologia da criação de necessidades irreais.
But what he's questioning is the whole system in which necessities are created by advertising and so on and so forth.
Das coisas. As coisas órfãs de luz assaltam nossos azuis dispersos. As peças vivas, lavas de sombra à deriva, zoam na humana paisagem rente à linha de montagem do desejo. Ou cintilância que o prazer das coisas lança, tralha que nos cerra os cílios, vida, loja de utensílios, víveres, onde outros rumos aos que no tecido ousem roer o fio de prumo dos que de coisas se cozem.
This poem consists of rhymed couplets, so obviously those of you who know Portuguese will see I have to make some changes, because if I don't make the changes, I lose his rhymed couplets, and if I lose the rhyme, I think I lose everything. I lose the poem, so. But I try to keep the spirit of the original. Things, orphans of light, attack our little tithe of sky, blue light. Alive, they writhe, lava of wandering shades, buzzing through human glades, a landscape of our kind, reflecting the assembly line of our desires. Or is it shimmering forth the very force of glimmering things themselves, junk that seals our eyelids shut, our lives, department stores, that glut of endless goods? Could there be another way for those within the web to fray the plumb line, plunge a knife into the fabric of our daily life?
Vamos para frente. Do espelho, que também trata de uma questão que eu já toquei ali atrás, o narcisismo, o excesso de narcisismo da vida moderna, da vida que a gente vive, de uma sociedade baseada na imagem, onde a aparência é mais importante do que o conteúdo.
This poem again treats of our social condition in which narcissism, or an exaggerated narcissism, is a big part of our lives, and which, of course, is carried to us through the image, the importance of the image. In this poem, the image will be yourself in the mirror. And so it's an attack on narcissism.
Do espelho. Tons de íris lago furta cor, de labareda sem o fogo vero. A face plana e muda, mármore inunda o que desnuda. E do poder que serve ao extremo de nos vender o que já temos, reina o espectro volátil das águas que da pedra tátil deságua, e a imagem seu selo a tornar-se asas do espelho, que frio se acasala sem cio, uma rima para silêncio.
Of the mirror, lake iris, iridescent hue of flames that flicker without true fire. Its surface smooth, serene, fair, a marble face that floods what it strips bare. The power, too, to sell or loan us what already is our own. Solid stone, it serves as host to a governing shadow, a watery ghost. That liquid image, though it flees, wings the mirror with utter ease, to an icy coupling, devoid of heat, a silent mating without meat.
Esse poema, pela sua métrica, pela organização dos seus versos e rimas, testa bastante a capacidade do tradutor.
This poem in its tight rhyme scheme and in its rhythmic pattern and so on and so forth is a real test of the translator.
O dístico final do poema, os dois versos, as rimas são rimas muito complexas para se transportar para uma outra língua.
The rhyme, particularly in the last couple of stanzas, are very complex to be transported into another language. For instance, actually, he has internal rhymes. Que frio se acasala sem cio, Frio is cold, CO is heat, as in the expression in heat, for the lust of a beast, the lust of an animal. And that's his internal rhyme, and I have to somehow keep everything going as rhymed couplets and keep the, for instance, the image of being in heat. I can't interrupt, the structure doesn't allow me to say in heat, and so I say devoid of heat, which sounds like calor, sem calor. But for those of you who speak Spanish or Portuguese, but by the time I get to the last line, a silent mating without meat, the ugliness, the brutality of the word meat, I think puts you in a position where somehow the shock of CO, you know, making love to yourself in the mirror, there's no CO, there's no lust, there's no animal lust, there's no blood lust. I think that's kind of implied by a silent mating without meat. You're just looking at your image, which is cold in the mirror and has no lust, has no human blood searching in it. Anyway, that was the fun of the...
Precisaria, portanto, ser um tradutor da competência de Mr. Levitin e obstinação.
You have to be as competent as Levitin to do that, and you have to be obstinate. As I said yesterday at Harvard, I'm not so sure if I'm competent, but I am obstinate.